Good evening. Good evening. Here we are. Happy New Year. First show of the year. My name's Chris Joyce. If you're tuning in now, thank you very much. Good evening, Andrew. Good evening, Mark Tempest. That wasn't an in solo. What that was is it's a rhythmic flowchart. So started off playing quarter notes, then half time triplets, then eighth notes, then triplets, then 16th notes, then I did quintuplets, and then I did double time triplets. I've seen people go up to 15 notes per beat with this, so it's you've got to start at the right tempo and you've got to bloody practice a lot to get up to that, I should imagine. But I've never managed to do that, so still working on it, still working on it. So who else have we got in the house? David, good evening. Great, it's nice to see some old faces back in here again. Hope everybody's had a nice Christmas, good New Year. Hope everybody's keeping safe and well. I'm going to do with some of these shows now. Why I've started off with that, what I just did then, is because that was all just playing single strokes, hand to hand. And in some of these coming live sessions, I'm going to look at rudiments. So if anybody's got any questions about rudiments, want to know anything, I'm going to go through them probably quite extensively. And I've been posting stuff onto Facebook of stuff I'm just practicing on a pad for my breakfast warm-ups. And it's just going through various rudiments and using this book a lot of the time to show you. It's called The Drummer's Complete Vocabulary, as taught by Alan Dawson. And it's put together by a guy called John Ramsey, who was one of Alan Dawson's students. And John Ramsey happened to then become the road manager for Art Blakey, and sometimes would stand in for Art Blakey when he was touring with him and do the sound checks with him. So great pedigree from all these people. So a lot of this rudimental stuff is from this book. It's a great book. Another book that I grew up with, and I've actually, is this one, the Buddy Rich Snare Drum Rudiments. Again, all really good stuff in here. Well worth for any drummer. So the rudiments, basically, anything, any rhythms, any fills, drum patterns, they stem from the rudiments. So getting to know the rudiments, you're training your hands, and it's just really handy stuff to have. I'm just moving that. I was playing before and I kept missing it. Well, I didn't keep missing it, but I did miss it. And I'm going to play a song in a minute. So I don't want to miss it and look daft. So if anybody's got any questions about rudiments, then please let me know. I'll explain now that the flowchart. So I'm going to shift the camera angle again. So what I'm doing with the feet, I'm playing the 1, 2, 3, 4. So playing 4 beats to the bar, bass drum, all 4 beats, hi-hat on 2 and 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now if you want, you can practice your heel toe routine whilst you're doing this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, and then the hands, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, leading with my right hand, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, and then the half time triplet, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, And then the triplets, 1, 2 triplets, 3 triplets, 4 triplets, 1 triplet, 16's, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And then the quintuplets. So these, what we've got is 6 notes over 4 beats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. So those half time triplets, 6 notes over 4 beats, what you're playing there is the 1 triplet, 2 triplet. You're playing on the 1, the let of 1, and the trip of 2. Beat 3, let of 3, trip of 4. 3 triplet, 4 triplet, 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet. And it adds a really nice, so if you're playing with a horn section or you just want orchestrating parts, it can be kind of really nice. So like, anyway, there's many ways of using that. So, little bit of single strokes, rhythmic flow chart, trying to keep that same tempo. So normally if I was practicing that, I'd practice it with the metronome, keep it really locked in, trying to keep all the notes of even volume, even intensity, so we're not accenting anything. But sometimes accessing things when you're first getting used to it, like triplets or quintuplets, does help a lot to get your phrasing right and the right number of notes on the right beat. So tonight, the song I'm going to do, where's my notebook? Here. Is, whose birthday is it? Does anybody know? Does anybody have any idea of whose birthday it is today and why I'm going to do this song? Dave Grohl, it's his birthday. He's 52 today. Young man. So, the song I'm going to do, Come As You Are. A real cool song. Came out, I think it was 1991. For us drummers, it's 120 BPM. Dave Grohl is obviously played with many bands, multi-talented guy, you know, musician, singer, songwriter, played with Nirvana, Foo Fighters, Queens of the Stone Age, them Crooked Vultures, amongst many other bands. Great musician, very, very talented guy. Obviously been around a long time now. And it's been interesting. I've done some research with doing this song tonight because I didn't realise that this, like I say, it came out. The album was Nevermind, which was Nirvana's second album, 1984. And before that, wait a minute, where is it? No, it's 1991. But there was an English band called Killing Joke who did a song called 80s with what is sounds like pretty much exactly the same guitar melody, guitar line. There was a bit of a kerfuffle with Killing Joke and Nirvana. Not sure what happened at the end of the day. I think maybe Nirvana had deeper pockets. It's usually the way with the law. Don't know if anything got settled out of court or what happened, but Killing Joke weren't very happy with Nirvana. And I think Kurt Cobain was actually quite worried about how Killing Joke felt about this, because the guitar line is pretty much exactly the same. And anyway, the record company said, it's great, we're putting it out. So it got put out. Now, interestingly enough, listen to a song called Life Goes On by The Damned, which came out in 1982. So two years before Killing Joke's 80s. And the song is very different, but again, very, 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 very similar guitar line. So the days of, you know, being litigious, I don't know. Anyway, like I say, Dave Grohl, his influences were Neil Peart from Rush and John Bonham from Led Zeppelin. So it's obviously spent a lot of time listening to them guys. Funnily enough, I was reading today as well, Kurt Cobain wanted Nirvana to sound like a cross between a band called The Knack and the Bay City Rollers. I couldn't believe that. He must have just been having a laugh with some Black Sabbath thrown in. Now, I'm not being a Bay City Rollers snob, but I find it a bit hard to believe that. Okay, so I'm going to play this song now. In the coming weeks, if you've got any questions at all, you can send them through to me anytime through Facebook or whatever. Anything you want to have a look at, have a talk about, you know, kits, cymbals, heads, sticks, hardware, percussion, give me a shout and I'll see if I can answer any questions for you. Okay, so I'm going to have a crack at this song now. And I've actually just clipped the beginning, so I don't play the whole of the bass intro, because it's the sort of thing that either Facebook or YouTube algorithms might pick up on and delete it. So we'll see what happens. Anyway, this song is Come As You Are. Right, let me just see if I've got everything sorted here. I'm just going to turn this mic off.
As a friend, as a friend, as I'm
mic back on. Okay, so nice song to play. Oh, somebody's saying here it's deadly boring practicing rudiments. Right, I disagree. It's like learning the alphabet. It enables you, it's an enabler. So, you know, it's part of your library, it's part of your vocabulary, and you just can then fit it into your playing. You don't spend your life playing rudiments all the time, but they are part of a learning process, I think. That's my opinion anyway. So put that in your pipe and smoke it. Okay, so interesting song. I mean, the drum part, it's not a dead difficult part. It's the bass drum follows the bass guitar line. Doom da da. So 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2 and da 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 da. Sits really nicely with the bass line. The fills in it are quite simple. With the sort of pre-chorus fill, you've also got a bass drum playing eighth notes underneath the 16th notes. So you've got this like 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. I'll just slow this down so you can see what I'm doing. So the bass drum's, this fill is going 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... wait a minute, chopping between cameras here. So you've gone from this very splashy crash cymbal part, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 1. It just plays for a bar actually, not 2 bars, so it's like 1, 2, 3 and 4, 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 1, 2, 3. So it really drives it along, and you've got that, so like you've got that 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4. So that mainly is your fills, and then you've got one where there's a flam, and it's a very basic sort of flam fill, so like 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, 2. Going actually takes it into the chorus. That happens twice in the song. And then there's one really nice tasty little fill where it incorporates a 16th note on the bass drum and ending up on an eighth note on the bass drum. So it's just playing it slowly. You've got 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 1. So I'll just give you that again. I'll give you from here. 1, 2, 3 and 3, 4 and 1. 1. So 1, 2, 3 and 3, 4 and 1. So 3, 3, 3, 3. You got that there. So it really pushes it. And then it's just like in the main, the verse parts, you've got the main rhythm. So you've got 1, 2, 3 and 4. Wait a minute, what is it? 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 4 and 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 4 and 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 1 and 2. And then he adds this offbeat snare in. 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 4 and 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 4 and 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and. So, putting all those parts together, you end up, there's no fat in it whatsoever. It's just, you know, it's really, there's nothing wasted. There's no extraneous bits. It's not, it's definitely not jazz. And it's really well constructed to my mind. And then the chorus parts, we've got this splashy open hi-hat with a crash cymbal at the beginning of every bar. And then, you've got that pushing it over every, so it's a two-bar phrase. So you've got, etc., etc. So that's a bit of a breakdown of that song. Bit of background about Dave Grohl, bit of background about Nirvana. I'm going to be back next week. I have no idea what I'm doing yet. I will be doing some more rudimental stuff. You can get into your rudiments. Rudiments, once you get into them and find out how you can use them on the kit, then you know you don't need to think of them as rudiments. You can think of them as fills, you can think of them as rhythms. You know, it's training your hands to be able to play in the moment if you're improvising, if you're doing jazz stuff, if you're doing funk stuff even. You know, there's a lot of benefits to learning rudiments. So, like I say, any questions, get back to me. I'm going to go now. Nice to see you. Hope everybody's keeping safe and healthy. Wear a mask. Do your bit. And I'll see you next week. Okay. Thanks very much.